Hello and welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather, and this is our adorable little tree frog. We're going to be spending a lot of time with him this month. A while ago, I wish I could tell you when, but I painted him in and I used a technique that I watched a gentleman named Ward Stroud use, and it was pretty awesome. He uses brushos. I used nuance powders. I think I actually used Color Lab powders that we made. Anyway, that's a long story. I never did this on air though, and I wanted to challenge myself this month by taking an old painting, something we'd done before, and doing it four new ways because we have like four shows this month. So that's what we're doing. We are going to take Tree Frog and redo him four times. What do you think of them apples? Not apples, tree frogs. Whatever. Anyway, so this is the line art for this tree frog, and right now the line art is available in our Facebook group. If you're not a member of the Facebook group, then you can't download him and do this yourself. But if you are, then you can do that. And I'm going to be actually removing that from the Facebook group and putting it up for travelers only later this week. So you want to get in there if you're not already a member of the Facebook group. That's one of the things you're missing out on. So, all right, I used a pink pen because then I could see the lines. You probably can't see it very well on there. Maybe you can. I don't know. Anyway, but I could see where I traced and make sure I got everything. And then you can kind of see those lines. How did that transfer? I used charcoal on the back of that. So charcoal on the back allowed me to transfer the lines, and we're set. That's all prep work. For those of you who come early, you get to watch some of that prep work. Pretty cool, huh? All right, are we ready to get going?
Yeah,
All right, thank you.
we've got Rose here and Jules and Andrew and Sandra.
Awesome. Glad everybody is in the audience. I'm getting we're going to be painting on this mixed media piece. I had actually prepared, you may b remember this, I prepared several, like I think six of these canvas panels. I had a whole stack of these canvas panels. They're black from Artist Loft. They were already pre-gessoed with black, and then I went through and glued paper to them. And they're ready for some fun. And I'm using those as a part of the 100 in 100 days thing that I have going on. It starts this week. And I'm going to be telling you more about that in the newsletter and on the website and in social media posts and the whole nine yards. So I'm not going to try and overload you right now with all of that information, but we'll get to it. So my idea here is to water down these acrylic paints because I want that paper to be seen through it. I don't know, we're going to see how it goes. So I'm watering down the fluid acrylics just enough to make them transparent. So this one is Deco Art Media Fluid Acrylics, and then I think I have one Americana paint. Deco Art paints are fun. They're really fun. They're very affordable, and they work pretty well. And I've had these for so long now. They work really well. So we're just going to paint Mr. Tree Frog in this transparent green gold.
Can they get the original tree frog on Spreezy or?
Oh, you know what? Sylvia owns the original.
Is that
Isn't
where it
that
went?
cool? Yeah, Sylvia owns the original tree frog, but
Or Society 6,
you
what?
can go to Society 6. Here, I'll show you. This is what I'm using as my guide for today is I'm on Society 6. That's where I'm at right now. And you can see we have it in a shower curtain. I mean, who wouldn't want this guy as a shower curtain, right? Oh, that's crazy. A throw pillow, some stationery cards, your cell phone case, tumbler, a mug. The tote bag is cool. Check out the tote bag. Isn't that cool? That's pretty neat, huh? Yeah. All on Society 6 right there. So I'm just using him as my guide while I paint here.
Enclave and Laura made it.
Hi guys, we're glad you're here. Very glad when everybody makes it. I know that the time change for us switching from daytime to
Evening.
evening, yeah, is it's been an adjustment for us too. We're like scrambling to get dinner done and scrambling to get everything set up, and it's a little crazy, but it's worth it because we can all do it together as a family, which has been so much fun. We were just dinking around before we went live, and it was hilarious. I kind of wish I could record that part without Mr. Crafter knowing, because then you'd get to see what Mr. Crafter is like when nobody's looking. Right?
You're a real dork.
If you don't know what MASH is, you will end up knowing what MASH is.
All of his comedy comes from MASH. We call it MASHisms.
Andrew says, my niece in Honduras has her own tree frog for her shower.
Yeah, she doesn't need a shower curtain tree frog, that's for sure. She, as a matter of fact, has a whole lot of critters that she doesn't need. Oh, that's too funny.
Laura says, I have tree frogs all summer long and they are getting in my house.
Yeah, I know they can be a nuisance for some people, for sure. All right, what's the next one? I think I want to use this yellow green light for the base of the leaf. As we go through this painting layer after layer, it's sort of a combination of mixed media with the paper glued down, but it's also going to be, we're going to add some different techniques and stuff, but it's mostly painting with acrylic paint. And it's kind of like filling in the lines or painting within the lines, but that paper in the background is going to add a whole nother dimension to this painting, I think. What's really cool is this painting that I'm painting tonight is going to be available as part of the 100 days, 100 in 100 days program that we are putting out there.
Working on launching.
Working on launching, yeah. I'm hoping to be able to make the announcement this Friday. We're basically, I'll clue you guys in. We're basically going to be campaigning for 100 days to get 100 new travelers on the website. Those are members who are supporting the Craft Shack and getting on the road. I'm going to switch to a bigger brush here so I can cover more ground. And if we can get 100 new travelers, my commitment is to do 100 paintings in 100 days. Cool, right?
I think so, and then we can get rid of some of your art.
Get rid of some of your art. That's lovely. That, my friends, is the Mr. Super supportive Mr. Crafter. Love you too, babe. Oh, I can't paint this and concentrate at the same time. Like I'm concentrating, not talking. That's what I mean.
Andrew says mixed media and indecision.
Okay.
Not sure why.
He has his reasons. An indecision of mixed media. Can I do it? We'll see. Going to get. So this is just the layer, so the first layer. So it's going to be very washy, very thin. Probably not very visible. Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, Jules. Nope, Sandra asked, did you add anything to the paint to make it transparent?
Just water. I'm just putting water on my brush. This real thin layer to start with, just so I can get everything blocked in so I know where to put the details. That's the goal here. Make sure I get everything. I'm going to put in just a little bit more there.
Jules says it's going to be exhausting, Heather, I would imagine. I'm assuming for the 100.
The 100 paintings in 100 days? I did kind of cheat, to be honest with you. I did kind of cheat already, got started on some. So I have a couple done. Do you guys want to see some of those? Get a few sneak peeks? I do have one that I completed. Here, I'll show this one. Actually, this is going to be a real sneak peek. Are you ready for this? This is huge. So on this Friday, I'm a part of a huge blog hop, and this is this blog hop that I'm a part of on Friday. The video is going to be going live. I actually did in my art journal something very similar to this painting right here. And so I loved it so much, I had to do it as a painting, as a canvas, so that way somebody could have it in their hands.
And that's
so,
perfection.
Isn't it perfection? So this is some foil. We're going to be using that foil on today's piece as well. So we'll see how I did that. You guys are getting like the pre-show, the pre-hop show. That's what you get for coming live and watching live. All right. None of that will make any difference. Yeah. So October 5th is the blog hop, and you may have already missed winning prizes if you're watching this in the future, but
they could watch it on Memorex.
The video is still there, and you could still watch the awesomeness happen. So T-Dog just asked, what is Memorex?
Yeah.
A little bit of laughter there from all of us old people for just a little bit.
The 80s thing.
Is that an 80s thing? Like 80s are just so old. That's
Sandra
awesome.
Says, looks like a glaze. Oh no, a glaze.
Yeah, it is. It's very much like a glaze right now. That's not a blaze, dear.
I like
it's
a blaze.
Yeah.
That's what she put.
Okay.
I like that. Andrew says, okay, 100 paintings in 100 days. Just think, 100 videos in 100 days.
I don't know if it'll be 100 videos, but definitely 100 paintings will get done. I'm trying to make a video for all the paintings that I'm doing. We'll see how it goes, though.
So, Mom, if you make a video off of every 25 paintings, you'll have 4 videos.
Yeah, I'll make more videos than that, but...
Lisa says hello.
Hi, Lisa. Glad you're here. If you guys would do me a huge favor, if you are on your desktop or even on a mobile device, you can do this. Hit that like button. And if you are so inclined, please share it out on social media. Tell people, come watch us. We need more activity in that area because we took too much time off. By we, I mean me. I'm to blame. I'll take the load for that one, but help me out, will you? I don't ask often, so I'm asking now. Please. Begging, even. You want me to get on my knees? I won't get back up, but I'm just being honest. All right, so this is good to block this all in, I think. And there's a little tiny spot here. Needs to go in right there. What do you think? Does this look okay? Is the lighting all right for them? Because I know on our monitor it doesn't look great, but what's it look like to the folks who are watching? Are they able to see? Oh, T-Dog is messing around over there.
It looks a little washed out. I think Andrew mentioned that.
Yeah, that's pretty close. That looks almost exactly like what? Don't mess with it. Okay. All right, so... we're just going to move in. Yeah, because it's really light on purpose. And if you are not an Instagram user, you can go to the website. The link is in the description down below. If you go to that page that we've linked there, you can actually see the Instagram feed. It's right there on the right-hand side. You can see the pictures that T-Dog is posting live right now.
Is that new?
A little bit. Yeah, I'm good. What do you want from me? I'm really good. I am really good. That's
Wait,
all I have to say.
You're gonna paint the eyes red.
The eyes are going to be red. That is correct.
Several people have shared.
Thank you guys. Appreciate it. Really do appreciate it.
Have a question about this frog.
What about the frog?
Is it poisonous?
No, I do not paint poisonous frogs.
Well, I mean the paint you could die from if you ate it.
Not this paint. This paint you could eat. I wouldn't recommend it. It tastes terrible, but I'm just saying it's non-toxic. It
There you go.
says
It's
so.
been approved. We can eat it.
No. If you were goofy enough to do it, you'd be safe. I'm just telling you not to.
It's like eating crayons when you're little.
Is it like eating crayons when you were little? Because I did not do that.
Oh, I'll bet you did.
Crayons were sacred. No way I would do that.
I'll bet you
Crayons were
did.
sacred.
No way.
Sandra had to throw food in. Frog legs are good.
Listen, we ate before the show on purpose because we knew somebody out there was going to be throwing food at us.
Thanks, Sandra.
That's not really what I meant, but mentioning food. Thank you guys for sharing. Appreciate that. Really do appreciate the likes, the sharing, the comments. All of that tells YouTube that what we do here is worth watching. So thank you so much. Thank you, Junk. See? Another wise young man out there. Save the crayons. All right. We are getting there. Now a little bit of orange. I'm pretty much going to copy what I did with the other one, but it's going to be in this mixed media format instead of watercolor. I'm thinking about redoing the watercolor. I'd like to know what you would like to see. Like, if, those of you out there watching right now, what would you like to see me do with this frog this month? Like, how would you like to see it evolve over the month in different formats? Don't everybody speak at once. I mean, hold on. Let somebody else have a try. It's all right. I was just kidding.
There's Becky that showed up and Janet.
Glad you guys are here. Thanks for being here. Oh, and the tree frog needs a name, I think. Oh, I can't do this one upside down. I'm gonna have to stick my hand in this. Okay, let's see. Get a little bit of paper towel, put the paper towel over, and I'm gonna go this way.
Andrew says, do one with psychedelic colors.
Like, but how? Like, I don't have no problem doing that, but how? Do you want it watercolor? Do you want it pan pastel? Do you want it?
Doesn't that just mean you make everything swirly?
No, but like, neon, purple, pink, instead of the typical green, and that's what I think he means. Maybe he'll correct me, but knowing Andrew, I'm pretty sure that's what he means.
Jules says paper piecing would look amazing too.
Ooh, paper piecing. I like that. Okay, so we got one for paper piecing.
He says yes, all the above.
One for. Well, you gotta choose one, Andrew.
I vote neon.
I have no problem with the color choice. I just need to know what media. So, like paper piecing, that's genius. We're gonna do that.
Black light.
Oh my goodness, black light. How could I do that?
Pan pastel would be good too. Collage.
We're definitely doing a collage. That's the paper piecing. So we'll do that for sure.
Somebody, Lisa's with jewels, and I don't know what that means.
She agrees. Paper piecing. That's what she means by that, dear.
How do you know she said, how do you know Jules said that?
Because you told me Jules said that. Paper piecing.
Oh, did I?
Oh my word.
Hmm.
Wow. Welcome to the show, honey. Welcome to the show. We're glad you came. His memory is bad, you guys. His memory is bad. What can we do?
What memory?
What memory?
Andrew says neon day glow paper piercing black light on black velvet.
All right, it's a 1 hour show, Andrew. What in the world?
Oh.
Welcome to the 24-hour stream where we're making the largest art piece in the world with every single finger in the face.
Yeah. All the things. That's what it's going to be. All the things.
You could do that over the next three.
I know, but I was doing four different ones. How do I do four different ones in one show, three times?
We'll do that, Andrew, only if you do something else.
What will Andrew do?
Oh. Jules says I thought my memory was bad.
Yeah, I mean, really, right? All right, so now it's time to start putting in some shadows. I think we should zoom in just a little bit. What do you guys think? Manual zoom. Manual zoom. Here we go. Manual zoom. Is that terrible? Yeah, but I did a good job. Didn't I do a good job? All right, I'm going to add a little bit of sap green. This is dark and sort of muted. That's what I'm going to use for shadows. Go ahead.
Andrew says, okay, forget all that. Do one in different color foils.
Ooh, foils. Oh, interesting. The jelly plate one would require some practice. That's right. Hello, Sylvia and Jules and Linz. Sorry. Thank you, Jules, for the reminder is what I meant to say to the replay. Oh, my goodness. This is so cute. Look at that. Just like that, his fingers just popped off the leaf. You see that? I'm going to use that same paint. Just go right underneath. I go straight to the details. I always go to the details, it seems. I like details. Details make me happy.
You know what you mean? You need a piece that's already been done, but not the details.
So that would be my show? I'm just here to do the details. I'm just here to do the details. You got a picture there, T? Just staying out of your way there, buddy. I have to look over to see where I'm missing. All right, this is just too cute, his little facial expression right here. Cute! Give them just a little bit of a line. Yeah, it's mixed media. You got it. That's a great hashtag to use, bud. How about photo by T-Dog, you guys? Follow that hashtag, photo by T-Dog, over on Instagram. You get to see some pretty awesome stuff.
Yeah, the one he just showed me is
really cool. All right, the trick to your keeping your paint smooth and flowing the right way is a little bit of water, but not too much. A wet brush helps keep things moving, but not too much, Heather, not too much. So I gotta go in here with this, lighten that up. There we go. All right.
Tanya just popped in.
Hi, Tanya, glad you're here.
Andrew says he's a French frog, so call him Le Frog.
Le Frog. Oh, where's Debbie to tell us the French word for frog? She would tell us how to say it in French. She would.
Frogué.
Frogué? I don't think that's right. I'm just guessing that's not right.
Jules says T-Dog's photos are amazing.
Woohoo! Big high five to T-Dog for the photo taking. Seriously, it's so awesome having you here, Mr. Crafter, because then T gets to go do what he loves to do, which you're really good at the setup stuff, and then... Did you? You high-fived yourself? Awesome. Very good. All right, let's move away from this before I overdo it. Not that I could ever overdo it, no.
Andrew says frog in French is grenouille. And I just butchered that pretty bad.
I was just
bad,
going
so
to say I'm pretty sure you butchered that pretty bad,
good.
But that's all right. Which is fine. We don't speak French here anyway, so it's okay.
It's okay. Jump will tell me how to pronounce it later.
Okay, so far I love him. What do you guys think?
Awesome.
I can hear their applause. I can hear him already. Okay. I like how I'm going to just lift it like this so you can see. I like that you can see through it to all that other stuff, but we need more color and more details. Just too muted. So, what do you feel like? It doesn't have enough saturation, he says. You know why? Because I'm the one who set up the camera today. That's why it doesn't, it's not right. Oh, that's not dry, so let's get out the... Any comments you want to share on screen, Mr. Crafter? No, don't do it yet. He's fixing saturation. Now would be a bad time to go. That's a little better.
Jules and Janet are saying I love him.
He's
Enclave
fun,
says
isn't
it's
he?
Nice. Lisa gave you four claps.
Woohoo!
Rose says it's awesome.
You know, it's a lot easier to paint something that you've painted before, by the way. It's almost like cheating.
Andrew says call him Croaky for short.
Okay. Coqui is how you say it in Spanish. Coqui? I believe that's the Spanish word for frog. Where's Michael? Michael would tell us that.
Seeing as how Google isn't here to tell us, we can make up whatever we want.
Well, I don't know if you're aware of this or not, but Google consults Andrew. So if Andrew said that's how you do it, then that's how you do it, period. The end of that.
Google gets its Google knowledge from Andrew.
Pretty
Google
much.
Knowledge.
Pretty much, yeah.
I like these mixed media pieces. I hope I didn't just interrupt you, right?
No, go ahead.
Okay. I like these mixed media pieces because when you look closely, you can see like lettering and
I know, that's why I wanted to do it, because I thought it would be kind of cool to see him, like, it almost looks like he was printed on top of papers. Kind of.
Because when you look from afar, you see the frog. When you look up close, and then you can see all the words and everything like that.
That's kind of what I was thinking, too. Am I on screen still? Because I can't see.
Yeah.
Nope. Move it like that. All right, here we go.
The art is, but not when you were.
I wasn't, actually, but it's all right. We'll pretend I did it on purpose. We can pretend that was all for you.
Andrew asked, he gets tiny little yellow irises, right?
No, they're going to be white. So see where I left it? It's like white. What is that?
No paint.
No, there will be white paint there, but what do you call that? Like glare? I don't know what you call that. I'll show
reflection.
You. We'll get there. We'll get there. We'll get there. Have patience.
I'm going to put up today's message.
Oh, that's a good plan.
Be at peace with each other. Mark 9, verse 50. It's
very apropos for today's world, isn't it, babe?
Yeah.
Very much.
Yeah, can't even say anything.
Yep. That's all you need to say about that. All right. I am going to outline my leaf and add these little veins. Give our little leave some attitude. So, like I was starting to say, when you do this and it's like kind of thick, it's not really, you guys can't see what I'm doing over here, but I'm just adding some water. And then let's see if I can do this where you can see. All right, I'm going to do it with this paint right here, okay? So I'm up here in the corner in this light green paint. I put my wet, very wet brush. It's very wet, like lots and lots of water on there, okay? Don't dry it off. Let that wet water go into the paint puddle. Then swirl it around. And then as you swirl it around and pull it towards you, you turn it. I don't know if you guys can see this or not, but I'm turning the brush as I pull it out. And that's going to determine just how much paint is on there. And then with that, I'm able to just very easily paint a line. It's nice, smooth. If I'm not shaking, it's a great line. Of course, I was shaking a little bit there, so. Thank you. So, you get the idea, right? I love how his little lip is turned like he's got some toed. I just love that. So, you do that with like these other colors. Now I can just go in here and wipe in a thin line and it doesn't get all gloopy. Gloopy is a word when you're painting, by the way. It is. It's a word. When the acrylic paint gets gloopy, you add water and do my little pull it out, turn it trick.
Rose
and
says,
gloopy is gone.
Highlights in his eyes.
Yes, highlights. Thank you. That is the word I was looking for.
And then she says, a little frog in Puerto Rico is called croaky. I think that was the charm that we got from there.
Yeah, we have, Andrew and I have a friend named John. As a matter of fact, if you guys remember the old Kraaft It Live, well, it's not very old, but the Kraaft It Live opening, John did the voiceover for that. Anyway, he's in Hawaii, and they call them croaky, croaky. I know, huh? It was a good opening for our show. We use it when we do the art, when we do the art concert. That's the art concert opening. We're not doing an art concert yet, but we will. We're getting there. You have a question. Go ahead, T.
The thing on the website that shows the pictures, when I do bunches of pictures, can they like scroll through the
page? Oh, yeah. All they have to do is click on it. It takes them right to Instagram.
Oh, okay, good.
Yeah, and they can see all the pictures that you've posted on Instagram, even if they don't have an Instagram account. Isn't that neat? That's pretty cool, isn't it? I should get some kind of points for that because I found out how to do that and installed it myself. Yes, I did.
Yeah. She works, has worked very hard on that website. It's unbelievable.
I try. I do try. Yeah, let's not talk about that. I think I have to pay the, I think the thing is due. No, the, like, you know, you have to register your site. I think that's due today. I should probably make that payment when we're done with the show here, I'm guessing. Too late, you're in my way.
You've entered my zone already?
You're in my zone, man. Did you touch the paint? Ah, excellent. Black paint on the knuckle there. Good job. You have been, you've been marked. Now I need my paper towel back. There's baby wipes back there somewhere.
It's on the floor. Rose asks, what did you say we click on to see the pics that T-Dog is taking and posting?
Okay, well, you can go to Instagram, but if you don't want to or you don't have an Instagram account, then you'll want to go over to the link in the description down below. It says it's all our links in one place, I think it says. And that takes you directly to the website where you can learn about the traveler option. You can see all kinds of stuff. And on the right-hand side is the box with the Instagram that you can see all that going on right there. And if you're on a mobile device, then you just have to scroll down. It's not on the right. It's scroll down to the bottom. So. Oh, he's so cute.
So I want people to comment as to how they or that they would like to see us come and do a live show near them.
What if nobody wants to?
Well, then I
so that's why I don't ask questions like that, because people might say they don't want to.
Well, I don't know what to
okay,
say.
Okay, now I don't know what to say to that. Never mind. Okay. I was just kidding. I'm sure somebody will have something to say.
Rose says thanks. Lisa says, love the close-ups, T-Dog.
Yeah, he sacrificed himself for that close-up there. Oh, I gotta pull that one out. So just gonna, this is, it's like I'm watercoloring, but with acrylic paint. It's kind of cool.
Lisa says she would like it.
So Lisa would like us to come to her neck of the woods, huh?
Yeah. I'm wondering if Rose was able to look at him. Look at those pictures.
Are you tapping on something? Because I keep hearing somebody knocking on something.
I don't know if I'm
okay.
Fidgeting.
As long as it's not with a spinner, I don't care.
Careful, don't put your hand in the paint.
Oh, no. I've learned. It's a minefield over there.
Oh, these details. I could get lost in the details, I think. We could be here all night. What? What I do now?
No, nothing.
Oh my goodness, he's so cute. I have to keep turning him because I can't see all the detail. All right, let's go with a little bit of red. Oh, I already have some red out. Okay. Just use the paint I got. And I'm going to put some texture dots here. Give them a little bit of texture. I did forget to look at the clock. My goodness, this time is flying by, you guys.
It always does. When you're having fun.
It doesn't always for me. Sometimes I feel like it flew, and sometimes I feel like it dragged on and never ended. That's not been like a normal thing, but there have been times.
Lisa just put up YW, and I'm thinking, what is that? I get it.
Never you get mind. It? Okay.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Oh. I thought it was you're welcome. I just wanted to make sure.
Oh, sure. Just a
so
little
what
bit.
What paints are you using again tonight?
These are DecoArt Media Fluid Acrylic. Except for the black. The black was Americana paint, by also by DecoArt. What I like about these fluid acrylics is they do work really well for this transparent painting.
They're very fluid.
Well, you know what? They're really not very fluid to me, but whatever. I didn't name them, so I guess they're a little bit more fluid than, say, the Americana paints are, but I am going to do four different frogs. So we're going to do a pieced, a paper pieced frog, and we're going to do, I think we're going to try to do a black light frog. I don't know how that's going to work, but yeah. Yeah,
Not
one
all
frog a
in
week.
one night.
Seriously, what kind of Superman painter do you
I
think I
thought you
am?
were doing like what you did last week, or the week before when you did.
Look at me paint four paintings in one night. Bam!
Nikki
No.
just joined.
Who did?
Nikki.
Hey, Nikki! Man, I hate when that happens. You lose a whole day.
Well, I think she was upset about Sunday again.
Hey, I don't blame her. Sunday has become my nemesis of the day, I tell you. Even when we win, I'm not happy, so.
That's because you were asleep. You don't remember winning anyway.
That wasn't the point. The po
That is the
that is not the
point.
point. The point,
The point is
not
that.
gonna get into it. I'm not gonna get into it.
You just
Football.
did.
We're not gonna get into it. Football. Oh, I love him. Okay, let me look at the thing. Let me see what we're looking at. Okay. We need some white and I need a little bit more definition around his little lips here. His lips need some more attention.
Yeah, Nikki says it was the rain. I just don't know that I believe her.
It's the rain. The rain is
What
very
rain is
upsetting.
that?
The rain outside, dear.
When?
Okay. The rain for some folks is very difficult physically, so I understand.
I heard they got 2 inches down at Sky Harbor Airport today.
They had to close your transfer station, so.
Yeah, that's multi reasons. I'm not sure why, but probably water was one of them. It's a lot of rain
That is a lot of rain.
for a desert that doesn't soak up
Well,
any rain.
that's just it. You have a hurricane dump a ton of rain real fast, and it really affects a place that doesn't. That it doesn't soak into the ground like it does in other places of the country. Just been weird, huh?
It's like, oh, I guess it rained. Well, I guess I won't see that for another couple of days or another month. No. Sooner than that.
Oh, I like Andrew's comment.
Okay.
All that is missing is bright red lipstick and long black curly lashes.
That's a
Oh
whole
no.
different painting, Andrew. That's a whole different painting.
That's awesome. You gotta do that on one of them.
On Andrew's psychedelic painting.
There you
One of
go.
them, the misses of the frogs.
Lisa says it keeps getting better and better every little thing you do to it.
All right. I want to do two more things. I'm going to do the white, but I think I'm going to wait to do that last. We need to manually zoom out. Manual zoom, manual.
I'm making the sound effect.
Yeah, I didn't like that sound effect. I thought I did that. You kind of freaked me out a little bit. Okay. This is what I want to do.
Surprise.
Some dark
Surprise
blue.
manual sound effects.
I'm going to take this dark blue and I'm put it right here. This is phthalo blue. It helps if you say the word, like the name of it. It doesn't really. I was just being silly.
Where's freshly cut grass?
We didn't use that tonight. Sorry. All right, and I'm just going to paint this. Oh my gosh, that is like a delicious color. Look at that. I'm going to paint me.
Delicious.
That is,
Really?
look at that
Well,
color.
she did say it was edible, so
Look at that color. That is amazing.
But it's not crayons. You can't eat it.
You can't eat it. All right, I'm just going to lay my bubble wrap in that. And we are going to go to town up in the sky. Bubble wrap.
How's the commute to that place?
Well,
Down up in the sky.
aren't you watching? See the commute for yourself.
Maybe that's my problem with my memory. I ate too many crayons
I
as a little
think
kid.
the fact that you ate crayons is the problem for sure. At least one of them. Remember when we were doing the art concert and I put bubble wrap in and I somehow got black on it and I didn't even remember doing it. I had to rewatch the episode to see when I put the black paint on.
Yeah.
I thought the black paint just kind of fell off and then it
No,
was
it
rolling.
didn't. I actually put the bubble wrap into the black paint and then placed it on there, but I honestly do not remember doing it, but I did. I have it on video.
BJ just popped in.
Hey BJ, glad you're here. Hope Abe is in the audience too. Say hi to both of you. Okay, there we go. That I like. That looks really cool.
Nikki said, was gonna say maybe too much paste eating as a kid.
Maybe. He could be guilty of that as well.
I think just the fact that couldn't eat craft supplies as kids kind of.
Could be an issue. It's possible. All right, we're gonna use
And it's
gesso.
normal. Every kid does it.
No,
You can't tell me they
I
didn't.
didn't do it. I didn't do it, so
Sarah just showed up.
it's an unknown event.
Oh, we're gonna leave that one alone. All right. I have like dirty water, so it's messing up my white. So I'm using gesso as my white because it goes over the top of everything.
Sarah says, super cute.
I'm kind of dumb.
So we are doing this tree frog. For those of you who just showed up, we're doing this tree frog all month long. So you're gonna see this cute little guy all month. You're probably gonna be sick of him by the time this is over, by the time October ends. But
Yeah, I'm glad because at least this isn't Halloween themed.
yeah, well, there's a reason why we don't do Halloween theme. But anyway, okay, so
Hey,
we are
Brian.
going to do this cute little tree frog all month long in different ways. And we've already had some votes as to what exactly we will be doing.
I wouldn't say they were votes, they were suggestions.
Okay, I'm counting them as votes. Those were votes to me. Okay? I asked, people said, I took it, the end. That's the I've decided that's what we're doing. All right, where do we put this? Right
Which
here?
one of the tree frogs you can add like a witch hat or something?
Nope.
No, it'll be all
No.
white.
No, I don't do
Or
that.
like the background could be dark or something. I don't know.
Creative Wings just said good evening.
Well, hello. We're glad you're here. So, anyway, if you wanted to paint along with us this month, you have an opportunity to get yourself this little tree frog if you are a member of our Craft Shack Facebook group. It's already posted there for members. It's going to be removed soon, and it will only be available for travelers on our website. I'm going to be doing that this week, posting it there. So if you want to play along, this is where we're doing that. I think we need to put some little pokey dotties here. I'm going to use the back end of my brush and these darker. He needs like freckles. Isn't that
And
cute?
it's Society 6 that has the
Yeah, you can
tote
get
bag or.
you can get a tote bag, you can get I'll go. So basically, I painted this guy a while ago, this tree frog. So if he looks familiar to you, that's probably why.
That's why I said I feel like I'm stupid, is because I was like, wait, this looks awfully like something you've done before, as I look at your iPad and I was like, I wonder why.
Yeah.
The mug looks
So,
really cool, I think.
yeah, I like the mug. I think the mug is awesome. And then, of course, the shower curtain. You can't go wrong with a gigantic shower curtain. Gigantic tree frog on your shower curtain. That would freak me out. I'm just gonna be honest with you. I'm being very silly about it because that would freak me out.
How weird would it be if somebody bought a house and purely decorated it with the
I think that could happen because there's people who like frogs that much. It could happen. It's possible. All right. I like it. I think it needs some more. Just a few more details. I know, I'm telling you, I could get lost in them. I know that I could. I'm sorry. I just can't let it go.
I know on Spreezy you can find some of your original artwork up there.
Yeah, and the original is actually, it belongs to
Yeah,
Sylvia,
not only
so.
this, but other stuff.
But there are definitely other items available for sure. And I am going to be posting more as we get closer to the 100 days, 100 paintings in 100 days. We're going to be posting some more original art over there as well.
Lisa wants to know where is the frop on the Facebook group?
Where's the frog? I posted it today. The outline, it looks very similar to that. And you can download it on the Facebook group. So, last thing I'm going to add to this are some. I don't know if I am going to add it actually. I think I just have to look at it and see if it's shadowed enough. I think it needs some shadow around the outside of the frog. So I'm going to water down this black and add to some blue here. Because I don't really want it to be a black shadow, but I definitely don't want it to be this bright blue either. So we're going to just mix some black and blue. Could use Payne's gray, but I already have this out, so why get more paint? Just a real watered down. Yeah, that's going to be perfect. We're just going to go around the back side here. This flat brush so I can get a real nice crisp edge.
I wonder if Lisa found that on the Facebook group.
Probably.
BJ says, I'll try and draw the frog.
Awesome.
Yeah, Lisa says, I guess I don't know where to find it.
Okay, well, I will tag your name in the post in the group. I posted it today. Boy, I hope I did it right. You know, I'm really not good at the Facebook, I gotta say. Practicing every day.
Am I a part of your Facebook
Cute.
group?
That's silly how that little bit of shadow just helps so much. And I'm going to go around this side over here because this needs a little bit more. This needs a little bit more. Oh, the silence kills me. You know that? It just does.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I
I
was.
know there's nothing we can do about it. You're busy looking for the picture in the Facebook group, so it's all good.
Yeah, and it's not on there.
All right, well, perhaps I already removed it, not even knowing that's what I did. I will have it there by end of the day, I promise. I didn't. I really didn't. I promise, though. As soon as we're done with the show, I'll put it there, I promise, Lisa. Sorry about that. Just gotta get these details because they just must be there. They just must. Oh, he's so cute. All right, that's it. He's done.
Yeah, you've said that before.
No, I didn't say that. Okay, I lied. I
Ah,
lied.
see, I told you.
I lied. I just realized this needs to be just a little bit of paper towel to dab that off so that way it looks a little bit more rolled. Okay, now I'm done. All right. What do you think? What do you think?
She put the paintbrush in the water.
Yeah, I did.
That's the sign.
Surrender. I surrender.
That's the sign.
All done. All done. That's what we used to do when the kids were little, remember? All done. All right, what do you think? He looks pretty good. That looks pretty fun. I think we did okay.
Love the bubble wrap.
In the sky?
Yep.
You like that?
Awesome, super cute.
All right.
He looks amazing. Love him. He's marvelous.
When we do this again, we're going to do some paper piecing. I liked Sandra's idea about jelly plating. That I think I know what she means, where you remove parts and pieces and jelly plate. I think I'm going to have to practice that one. We're going to be doing this all month long. Tree Frog, I hope you don't get sick of him because he's our buddy for the month of October. I wanted to put some of this antique pearl on where his eyes are, like, as highlight. That's what I wanted to do.
Why didn't you?
Well, because the time.
Time is of the essence.
Oh, well, we'll get to it. We will get to it, I promise. So, you guys, thank you so much for joining. We're going to use that this stuff in one of the next ones. We're going to do, Andrew suggested, like, psychedelic, black light, all of the stuff, neon. We'll see. We'll see what we do. All right. I'm going to say goodbye. Thank you, everyone, so much for joining us live. And if you're watching the recording, please leave us a comment and let us know that you were here watching. That really does matter to us a great deal. So we love doing Kraaft It Live. We love that we are able to do this as a family. I'm so grateful to Mr. Crafter and to T-Dog for all their help. Again, check out Instagram for those behind-the-scenes photos, close-ups, and awesomeness that T-Dog does there. So thanks, everybody. I hope you have a crafty day. Bye-bye.